estimated in 18, I think. So we brought the engine here, and with the help of Danking, the marketing director, I managed to photograph it with the original engine, and then Dan mentioned the possibility of volunteering on the railway, and I was just like, okay, I have to come back.
And I did.
So we've hooked you in. We've hooked you back, and now you're part of the team. And, you've come a couple of times now from Hungary, right?
Yeah. This is my second year.
Well, together with Annette, you make an amazing international crew, and I think that's part of what makes the Tackling so special, is it draws people in from around the world, doesn't it? I think it's fair to say that, you know, I come up from London sometimes to come and play trains, but it's the railway with a heart of gold, we often call it, and it's the world's first reserve railway. It's the people here that really make it. Let's go meet some more of those people. Actually, let's go this way. Let's go over here. Right, okay. Sorry, let's go over here. I'm going to walk over this, but this is definitely safe if I do so. Now. A couple of people here, one of whom I think is actually having his first day on the railway. Harry, hello. I'm not going to shake your hand because you're really covered in grease.
Yeah.
This is your first day volunteering.
Yes, it is.
Well, thank you very much indeed. Where have you come from?
We come from the Bluebell Railway down south in East Sussex.
Brilliant. So you've jumped ship for a day.
And yeah.
Coming up. Great. And what are you doing down here today? What here?
At the moment, just taking off all the grime and the motion, and it gets on.
Who's that underneath? Someone's hiding underneath. Right, so you guys are cleaning the engine. So it's important, right? First thing in the morning, before they go out to the public, to get it just looking great.
Yeah, so nice and clean, and
what's brought you here?
Well, when I was younger, watching the Little Blue Engine and the stories it encountered, and obviously them being based on
the Scarlet Railway.
Yeah,
absolutely.
And it's always been a dream to come down here and work.
I'm very pleased you have. We'll catch up with you later, Harry. Thank you so much.
Sure.
Lovely. So that's number three. Just here. This is the engine number three over here. You can see number three. This is called Sir Hayden's, his real name, named after the former general manager of the railway and the owner of the railway. Owner of the railway. Bad historian. Bad historian. Known in the Tom the Tank Engine Railway series, but this is by Reverend Audrey, it's known as Sir Handel. Tom Wilkes, who was indeed one of the men who sent the railway, this is named after him as well. Now, in fact, in the running I wasn't expecting to see this getting steam up there, this is a surprise. This has been being fixed by volunteers and the team. Now, there are not volunteers here, there are some paid members of staff that are tied in. Remarkably, because the railway does make money, and it has to go, it's a commercial railway as well. Down here, we've got Ross. Ross, you joined the railway.
Yes, the
S&T
of railway.
Lovely. So S&T, what does that mean?
Signal and telecom, I think.
But you've been thrust into service today, doing cleaning as well, right?
Yeah, I started with cleaning and then became an apprentice.
So you started as a volunteer and now you're here as an apprentice, learning stuff, which is great, which is a brilliant way of growing skills, right?
Yeah.
But what do you enjoy most about being at TR? Apart from being a trade.
Well, the people, really. Most of them.
Yes, apart from the ones that come into you, you're on camera.
Yeah, apart from the ones, yes.
Sorry, Ross. Thank you very much. Right, okay. Now, as you can see out there, we've got number six. Now, number six is known as... What's it called?
Douglas.
Right. This is Tom. Tom, I've known for a number of years. But Tom, you've been volunteering here for quite a long time, haven't you?
Yes, since I was 14, so this is my fifth year this year.
Yeah.
The reason I was to volunteer here is because Dad's over there.
That's Tom's dad there.
He works here. And then there's his dad, his brother, and then their dad, they volunteered to the railway, and then I just decided that I wanted to do it as well, so...
So there's a long family association with the Curtises, isn't there, on the railway?
Yes, yeah, so...
And you're the latest in a very long line.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much, Tom. And Tom, what are you doing today on the railway?
So today I am second manning on Loco 11, which is the Bagley Diesel.
Right.
Which is parked up the head shunt at the moment.
Ah, so that you're going to be, I'm going to come this way, you're going to walk this way, because they're bringing the engine into the shed. So you're taking this up the valley to Bringlass on the Finch of Doom. Oh god, the Finch of Doom in that rain out there. Later on. Now, come down here. Now, let's look. Okay, right at the top down top. Now, are we boating up?
There is some steam in this.
There's some steam.
Where do you want to end up there?
Let's watch that happen, shall we? Let's watch that happen. Because,
clear.
See what's happening today.
Right,
free. Clear.
Hang on. Clear. Right, so this is number three. I'll be honest, this is my own personal favourite. Right, so number three. What's going on here? Why are you doing that?
Just because the Henry's quite low on this one, so put the extension on so you can definitely reach the ducts throughout the shed.
Oh, I see. Now you said it's again, it's the exhaust, all the fumes go straight up out of the chimney.
That's
it. Up the stuff. Right, now. Alex.
James.
Welcome to the baptism of fire, being live on camera as well at the same time.
I'm just aiming at the moment, aiming number six. Once we've done the sun thing.
You're done your job.
Thank you. I've just been working on this bit here.
So you're cleaning up and you're just greasing it over with an oily rag and cleaning it up ready for public to see.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And what time did you have to start this morning?
Oh, I think it was, we had to get here by 7:30, so it's waking about only 6:30-ish. Oh, right. Getting ready.
It's an early night then, okay.
Yeah. Right.
And what happened today? What happened once you finished on the engine? What are you going to do then?
I'm not really sure, to be honest. I do you think stay at the shed generally work around here? Work crossing gates?
Well, in that case, we're going to see you later. We'll be back here at the shed, and we'll see for the crossing gates later on, because we've got stuff to do. I'll let you get back to your team, because I know there's a lot more to do. I can see everyone's still getting the engines ready. And you're going down into the pit. Oh, blimey.
This is the dirtiest job I think I ever had. Other than cleaning the smoke box and the chimney because it's water.
Oh, that's nasty. You can see everyone here is generally very, very hot. I don't stay out at red because being sunny Wales, of course, sunny Wales means that. Liquid sunshine, we can call it, I think. We've got the team and they're all getting ready to head off. Down to the wharf station. But the team looks so lovely. I think about 12 young members are here at Pendre, all who've come so very far, and some of them not so far, to be part of this railway and get it working for them. So we're going to probably sort of finish up in a moment. But I just want to let you know that we've got a poll live on Facebook. If you look down there, you'll see. I think maybe up there, I can't quite tell because there's some editing over there. Live on Facebook right now, we've got a poll. And I'd like you, please, tell us, what's your favourite Scarlowe railway engine? Is it number 3, Sir Handel? Or is it number 4, Peter Sam? Or as we know it, I think, Sir Hayden and Edward Thomas? But those engines are out and about today, and we're going to go meet those later on, and the crews who are firing them. Anyway, thank you for joining. We're going to let these wonderful folk, all of them, some young, some not so young, some fairly young, but we're going to leave this team to get back to their, some really, really very grubby jobs indeed down there. I mean, really, that's dedication down
there. Hello!
And I'm not
cleaning
number 2.
No, Annette's number 2. Where's Annette gone? Annette's there. Annette's cleaning number 2. Becky over there. So Becky over there is one of the coordinators of all the teams here. This is being fired up, isn't it? Lovely. Right. So we're going to leave the team now because they've got to get number 6 out and get number 3 out. Harry's got to finish cleaning the wheels. Alex is going to finish there, and then we're going to be done. We're going to catch up with all of you guys very shortly. I've lost my sheet already, but it's 10:50. We're going to see you at 10:50 aboard the Bench of Doom, but also a real visit to the recreation of the Audrey Study up in the museum, where we have got Reverend Audrey Study, all of his stuff, his pipe, his notebooks from the Thomas the Railway series, all those books he wrote so very long ago, 75 years ago. We'll be up there and show you inside this lovely, lovely place. We'll see you up there, because this railway, of course, is the inspiration for so many of those books, the Scarlowe Railway, everything from Four Little Engines to the Gallant Old Engine. Anyway, we'll take you up there shortly, but thank you all so very much for joining us in this first episode of Talithin Live. We'll see you at 10:50. Thank you, and good morning.